A new mall in Quezon City is seen to elevate Cubao as we know it, Jackie Pascual reports.
Despite economic challenges, the Araneta Group is bullish on growth. Proof of their commitment to invest further in commercial development is the opening of Gateway Mall 2. With many high-end brands opening soon, the mall is targeting the upscale crowd.
What we're happy about it is that we are bringing in people who could probably will not consider Araneta before to back to our places. This is not your father's Cubao.
The 5 billion peso expansion is connected to the Gateway Mall, Araneta Coliseum, and the soon-to-open Ibis Styles Manila Hotel. It features a huge LED ceiling, nature-inspired design, gardens, and a 1,000-seater Catholic church. Mall officials are confident domestic consumption remains high post-pandemic.
Revenge spending, revenge dining, it is indeed happening.
World-renowned chef Margarita Forres and family opened several restaurants at the said mall, betting on its proximity to Araneta Coliseum as well as the vibrant food industry.
It's super booming. Actually, you'll see that there's a lot of expansion going on for many of the restaurant groups. The Coliseum, the arena, really kind of like is the magnet, is the attraction. But what's nice also that even when the shows ended, like when the games, the basketball games ended, we're still surprised that the market is still big.
Despite high inflation, the operator and merchants remain optimistic. The crowds will come.
There has to be an impact, but hopefully, again, our retailers and our operators are coping with that. Makikita mo naman, may mga value offering sila.
I think that we've become really creative with how to sort of counteract the higher costs of our ingredients by creating new dishes and also creating kind of like, you know, like marketing programs and interesting new stuff.
A plan for Gateway Mall 3 is already in the pipeline. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Filipino-American musicians grace the all-Asian lineup of the first ever TFW Music Festival in Arcadia, California. Steve Angeles tells us more.
Weekend Mix joined forces with the 626 Night Market for the first ever TFW Music Festival. Fans flocked to the Santa Anita Park racetrack to catch the all-Asian lineup.
10 out of 10, no complaints. Go Umi, Umi, Umi!
Filipino-American artists like Melissa Polinar, Jeremy Passion, Jessica Domingo, and Pilo brought in the good vibes and high energy that they've been known for.
We about to just come bring that good energy, come have a good time.
Well, the two-day festival featured an all-Asian lineup. Fans from all backgrounds came far and wide, claiming coveted front row spots to expand their music horizon.
Some of it was just me wanting to learn about other like artists and expand my music taste. I think it's awesome to always like just like immerse yourself in different cultures. But I'm very open to music, and I've been surprised with each artist, and I think they're like amazing, talented, and I think it's a great way to like share culture.
They were great. It was a lovely time photographing this festival, and I can't wait for next year.
These artists see TFW and Mix as a chance to empower more of their kind, especially Asian musicians. Japanese-American neo-soul musician Umi has been making international waves. With songs in English and Japanese, she has been touring Asia, including the Philippines.
I think the opportunity to connect with each other as artists and with a broader crowd, because we get to meet other people's audiences, and so I think it just brings the whole community together.
And the party won't stop just in Southern California. Just a few days after the TFW show, some of these artists will also be putting on a show north of the border.
Umi and Korean-American pop sensation Justin Park will both participate in Mix's 1MX Toronto on September 10th at the Budweiser stage.
Everybody come see me in Canada. I haven't been there in so long, so come see the new Evolve show. It's going to be amazing, and you're going to feel great.
It's the greatest time. As you can see, I'm sweating a lot, you know what I'm saying? But TFW is probably the best concert I've done this whole year, so y'all better come out to Toronto. Y'all ready to see us? Just Park in the building, baby. I think it helps unite us, it brings us together, and you know, I feel like in the past couple of decades, there's been a lot of divide between a lot of Asians, but it's like bringing us together is the main goal, you know what I'm saying? If we stand together, we have the most power, and honestly, the most joyous time possible, so I'm really thankful to 1MX for bringing us together like this.
Umi and JP will be joined by some Filipino acts such as Ben and Ben and P-Pop Aces BGYO. Last minute tickets can be found on Ticketmaster and more info on Mix.Global. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Arcadia, California.